श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा, गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। विल रीड फ्रॉम वर्स नंबर 26। रज्जु सर्पवदात्मानम् जीवं ज्ञात्वा भयं वहेत् नाहं जीवपरात्मेति ज्ञातश्चेन्निर्भयो भवेत्। आत्मा वभासयत्येको बुद्ध्यादीनिन्द्रियाण्यपि दीपो घटादिवत्स्वात्मा जडैस्तैर्नावभास्यते स्वबोधे नान्यबोधेच्छा बोधरूपतयात्मनः न दीपस्यान्यदीपेच्छा यथा स्वात्मप्रकाशने निषिध्यनिखलोपाधीन् नेति नेतीति वाक्यतः विद्या दैक्यं महावाक्यैः जीवात्म परमात्मनोः। व्हेनेवर वी यूज एनी मीन्स ऑफ नॉलेज we are definitely influenced by that means of knowledge. For example, if we are using our eyes to see the colors and forms, and if our eyes are having some problem, then in that case our knowledge will be influenced because of the limitation of that means of knowledge. Like for the first time when somebody gets the glasses, we are unable to see properly. So we take the paper in the hand and try to see different distances. The accommodation, the focal length adjustment of our eye muscles has become non-functional. Then what we do? Then the function of the eye muscles is handed over to the biceps. So whether you adjust your focal length by adjusting the bulge of your iris, or you adjust the place where the book is. So the instrument of knowledge influences the knowledge. Similarly, understanding. If somebody is extremely extrovert and objective in his pursuit, therefore many students who are very sincere, they are scientific minded, and everything they like to objectively understand, and they fail. See, few years before I was in England, and one person asked me this question: Swamiji, what is your opinion about the God particle? Now they cannot get out of that. Particles can happen to matter. God is not a matter. How can particles be there? And in the infinite, fractions are only imagined. They are not real. Like the north, east, west, south, are they real? They are upadhik. Because of the upadhi, they are called as north, east, west, south. But actually they are not. But whenever you are studying the scriptures objectively, then we start developing concept. See? Like the concept. God is omniscient. Now why is he omniscient? Because we are having limited knowledge. So what is opposite of limited knowledge? Unlimited knowledge. We are ekadeshiya in one place. God is all pervading. Completely wrong understanding. God is not pervading in the whole space. The space is in the God. See? But this objectivity in pursuit keeps the truth away. Therefore, here the teacher says, Nishiddha nikhilo upadhin. Give up all the upadhis. Upadhis are the instrument through which we gather knowledge. So we want to know the God through the eyes. Then what we'll do? We'll create a picture of poor God. See? And then what will be our God and what will be the God of a buffalo? See? Our God is, we have got two hands, he has got four hands. See? We require to buy a mobile phone for connecting with the people. They have got the shankar. See? And our friends are out of the reach. His friends are not out of the reach. Go anywhere, he is there. In short, we try to picture the God according to we have understood ourselves. So what will be the God of the buffaloes? A white buffalo. The other day I received one very intelligent WhatsApp. On the back side of a truck, it was written, Buri Najar Wale, Tera Mu Safed. Not color. Because they're all are black. So, Nishiddha Nikhilo Padhin. All Upadhis. Upadhis are the body, the sense organs, the organs of action, the mind, the intellect, and Upadhi is I, the knower. When all these Upadhis are Nishiddha, reject them. Nishiddha nikhilo upadhin, then na iti vakyataha. See, the truth cannot be spoken of in terms of is. Arupam, avyayam. See, no form, no change, ashabdam. So what we know, that alone is the reference point. In one word, the unknown is indicated with reference to the known. See, do you know Guptaji? Unknown. I don't know Guptaji. You know Kapoor? Yes. This Guptaji is his son-in-law. Then you come in contact with Guptaji. And he cheats you sufficiently. Thereafter, next time you want to know, Guptaji, I know him very well. Why? Aparokshanubhuti. Direct experience. You don't require Kapoor in between. But till such time, the Guptaji is known, till then we require the reference. So do we know the truth? No. What we know? We know colors and forms. Very good. That which is without colors and forms is Paramatma. Oh. What oh? Get away from your eyes. Don't try to see Paramatma. See? This is the meaning of neti neti iti vakyataha, na iti, na iti, na iti. So whatever we know, reject all that. And what cannot be rejected? That thou art. Nishiddha nikhilo upadhin, neti neti iti vakyataha. Then we come to the mind. Another upadhi. See? Darshan do ghanashyamanath mujhe chasma lag gaya hai. Be very attentive. Don't struggle to see God. Let Him express through us. He is searching for an instrument through which to express. Poor God, he doesn't have the eyes. So let us lend our eyes to him. He doesn't have the speech. Let us give our instrument to him. He doesn't have hands. Let us give our hands to him. But how it can be done? When our hands stop working selfishly, when our mouth stops talking good about oneself and bad about others, when our eyes stop seeing the ugliness in the world, then we have emptied ourselves. And when we empty ourselves fully, completely, then he takes over. See, friends, neti neti iti vakyata. Nishidya nikalopadin, neti neti iti vakyata. Vidyat aikyam mahavakyaihi, jivatma paramatmanoho. Then the mahavakya, tattvamasi, by that come to discover the identity between the jiva and paramatma, identity between the husband and the man. Now who is suffering? The husband. What is he? The man. So what sadhana this husband has to do to know that he is a man? See? Don't fight and argue with wife. How simple it is? Similarly, don't get involved and entangled in the relative world. Many of us have got this problem with reference to children. If you want to get rid of your children's problem, I tell you a simple technique. Children are born through us. They are not born to us. What we give to our children is only a already constructed condominium. But the one who is living in that body is not created by parents. We have the properties to rent it out. Now in that rental property, what type of customer will come? No, if you have to stay here, you should be Krishna Bhakta. You should not eat non-vegetarian. Then your property will remain without tenant for all the life. You have no control. But we start assuming that we can control everything. These are the basic things. Therefore, Vidya Daikyam Mahavakyahi, the Mahavakya is Tattvamasi, that thou art. Now understand this. Ocean can become the waves. But wave can never become the ocean. God can become the jiva, but jiva can never become the God. But when we want to become God and bless everybody with a snuff mudra, you are going the wrong way. See, friends, all specialities dropped. Only being without becoming anything. So when a wave dissolves in the ocean, she doesn't become ocean. Then she is water, she was water, and she will continue to be water. In the same manner, we don't become God. We dissolve in the absolute. See, friends. And what is absolute? Name dveshosti na priyaha, Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita. The ocean says, none of the waves are dear to me nor against them. If it's a tsunami, the ocean is not worried. Oh God, why this has come? No. If it is a small ripple, oh very good, cute, cute. No. Be attentive. From the water's point of view, there is never any ocean. Nor there any wave. From the water's point of view, there is neither the river nor a gutter. In short, this jivatma paramatmanoho aikyam vidyat, means change your standpoint in life. If we live in the relative standpoint, there is no solution to any problem in life. The moment you change the standpoint, everything is okay. Like we have to work in this world and we have to get our work done. So keep your relationship only with that working thing. After that, delete. Whether somebody is good or bad, how does it matter? Kaam ho raha hai na, finish and finish now. Don't create relations in this world. See, friends. Otherwise, we get lost and then we suffer because of that. So, nishiddhe nikhilo padin, give up all the conditioning through which we are functioning. Neti neti di vakyataha, I cannot be the body. And don't have that parroting. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. Nothing is going to happen. What is the meaning, I am not the body? Work on this. See, once I was in Uttarkashi, many years before. And that time parroting, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not the body. And that time the dam was not there. So Ganges used to flow in full glow, like here. And then with that mantra, I am not the body, I am not the mind. And in that cold water I entered. And I realized I'm not the body. It was so cold. See, friends, that is not the meaning. I am not the body. What is the burden or the load of this knowledge? If I am not the body, I am not a man or woman. I am not rich or poor. This world is not real. Desires cannot be about the illusory world. In short, I am not the body means the burden of possessions and relation is undone. Are we not experiencing this in the deep sleep? In deep sleep, our experience is I am not the body. Therefore, I have no possessions, I have no relations. And when these two things are dropped, what is our experience? Happiness. And how do we know we are happy in deep sleep? Because of the sound. Therefore, they call it sound sleep. A sleep that produces sound is sound sleep. They are all the social workers. Sound for the society and sleep for themselves. Sarva bhuta hite rata. Vidya daikya mahavakyahi paramatma jivatma paramatmanoho. So when we are giving up the conditioning, not only mechanically, I am not the body, etc., but the impact of that should be reflected in our life. Like many of us go to satsanga very regularly, but our individual life is concerned, disgusting. Such people bring bad name to satsanga. They say, Muh mein Ram, bagal mein churi, they say. See, friends, it is a responsibility to be a satsangi. It is not a fashion. If somebody is inspired by our lifestyle, and then they come to know that he is a student of such and such subject, then he or she will be inspired. But if our life is like this, you know, going every day to satsanga, but as regard the home is always on fire. No. See, we have to recognize this meaning of the nishiddha nikhilo padin. Now after this body identification is taken care of, then we come to the sense organs. Are we slaves of our sense organs? And of all the sense organs, try only with one. And that is our tongue, which is two in one. In our Bhimpura camp in Gujarat, on the banks of Narmadaji, we have every year camp. And it is a place of Anandamayima, very beautiful place. And when we all sit together for taking food, together we chant, everybody. We start with that Anandamayi Mata Ki Jai, Anandeshwar Mahadeva Ki Jai, about a dozen jaykaras. And at the end, that person says, Aaj ka bhojan. Then everybody says, Bahut achcha hai, without eating. Now you start eating. Ye khara bhai, abhi to kaha tha achcha hai. Control the choices of food in your life. One of the very important spiritual practice. See? Enjoy. But don't suffer because something is there or something is not there. Like I told you, Bengan I don't like. Yesterday, Bhagwan came. See? So I did not eat it at all. Otherwise, he will come and again put it there. So at the last only, when he is not coming, over. Brahma arpanam, Brahma vi, Brahma arpanam, Brahma arpanam. See, friends. So, nishiddha nikhilo padin. We have to control our tongue as regards tasting is concerned. And also as regards talking is concerned. It's two in one. Who asks you? How many things we keep on talking unnecessarily? And in that talking, if you observe this, when we talk to others, we talk about our past. And when we talk to ourselves, we talk about our future. The net result is, we are never in the present. See? So, nishiddha nikhilo padhin. Then we come to the mind. Give up the conditioning of the mind. Don't become emotional. See? Emotions are the ornament on human personality. But emotionalism, if you don't do this thing, I will not take food. Who cares, don't take? If you don't listen to me, I will commit suicide. Thank God. Such dumb people, they are a problem for the whole family, for the whole society. See, those who think about committing suicide, and those who want to live long, both of them are victims of body identification. If you commit suicide, in the next life you will be born as a bhoot. See, then you will continue to suffer. Here you are suffering with body, there you will suffer bodiless suffering. But suffering will not go. Mana, the mind, then the intellect. Nishidya nihilo padin. How to reject the intellect? Vado na avalambyaha. Do not get lost in argument and logic. See? Because that strengthens our wrong notion. And the simple mathematics is, if we lose the argument, we are the loser. If we win the argument, but we lose a friend. Now decide, what is worth losing? Therefore, nishiddha nikhilo padin, neti neti iti vakyataha. Then slowly we will unburden the conditioning through which we are expressing, and then we will be able to focus our awareness on our own being. Continuing further, आविद्यकं शरीरादि
आविद्यकं शरीरादि
दृश्यं बुद्धबुद्वक्षरम्
दृश्यं बुद्धबुद्वक्षरम्
एतद्विलक्षणं विद्यात्
एतद्विलक्षणं विद्यात्
अहं ब्रह्मेति निर्मलम्
अहं ब्रह्मेति निर्मलम्
आविद्यकं शरीरादि स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द कॉजल बॉडी आविद्यकं शरीरम अप टू द ग्रॉस बॉडी इदं दृश्यम द होल ऑब्जेक्टिव वर्ल्ड इज बुद्धवद अक्षरम लाइक द बबल्स सी कॉन्स्टेंटली क्षरम constantly changing. Now this one applies objectively. Our body is constantly changing. Our faculties are constantly changing. Our values are changing. Our priorities are changing. Everything is changing. But we remain ever the same. And therefore that we changes cannot be the real one. So avidyakam shariraji drushyam. So what is the drushyam? The waking world with the waker, waking world and waking experiences, the dreamer and the dream world and the dream experiences, the deep sleeper and the deep sleep world of absence and experiences, and the samadhi beginning and end. All of them are constantly changing, but the substratum remains ever the same. How do we know we are practicing this? Dekho, suno, mat bolo. Then we have given up the value of reality to this world. When we see the mirage, do we start thinking and discussing that this mirage waters can be harvested? What will be the chemical composition? No, we know it is mirage. So we see, we hear, but we don't talk. In the same manner, when we take this world as an illusion, now be attentive. What is the meaning of illusion? This mic is existence. The second mic is existence. In between, there is neither this mic nor that mic. Then, I am there. So as regard existence is concerned, object number one exists, object number two exists, and in between, I, who established the existence of these two objects, also exists. So on one existence, these are the three conditioning superimposed. Object number one, object number two, and the knower of the two objects. All the three of them are supported by the same existence. And existence is not gender bias. It has nothing to do whether sentient or inert. But this example doesn't click us because of the examples given. Like in all the ornaments, it is the gold only common. So material cause of all the ornaments is gold. Material cause of all the pots is the clay. In the same manner, material cause of the whole world is Brahman. Then the question comes, whole Brahman, whole world, that means the world is inert as well as sentient, jada chetan. How can the same Brahman be both jada, the inert, and chetan, the sentient? How it is possible? And we are unable to digest that. Only because our attention is on jada chetan. Jada chetan, inert and sentient, is the expression of the conditioning, not what he is expressing. Like the example I gave you, like electricity, stagnant in the bulb and moving in the fan. So are these two types of electricities? The differences are on account of the conditioning. So in one condition, the existence can express only as existence, but in the sentient being, the existence can express both as sentiency and inertness. Thus, there is one reality. This is what is called in Vedanta, the simultaneously material and efficient cause of the world. Material cause, matter of which the world is made, an efficient cause who made the world. Thus we are simultaneously existence and knowledge, but the mic is only existence. Why not knowledge? Because of the conditioning of the instrument. इन दिस मैनर आविद्यकम शरीरादि दृश्यम बुध बुधवत्म एतद् विलक्षणं विद्यान् अहम् ब्रह्मेति निर्मलम्. सो देन हाउ डू वी नो दिस माइक आई एम नॉट, दिस माइक आई एम नॉट, बट स्टिल आई एम. देयरफॉर आई नो माय बीइंग एंड देयरफॉर वी टोल्ड वी आर नोइंग एंड बीइंग मर्जेस, दैट इज द एक्सपीरियंस अहम ब्रह्मास्मि. And this knowing and being can merge only if the instrument of knowledge are not involved. If the instrument of knowledge is involved, eyes, then we'll try to see God. If instrument of knowledge is the ears, then we'll try to hear the flute. See friends, that experience which does not involve any instrument of knowledge that is mentioned here, etad vilakshanam vidyat brahmeti nirmalam, this is the ultimate truth. Continuing further, dehanyatvanna me janma jarakarshalayadayah shabdadi vishayai sangah निरिंद्रियतयानच. नो देहात अन्यत्वात नमे जन्म, आई बीइंग अदर देन द बॉडी आई एम नॉट बॉर्न. नाउ दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विच वी आर रिफ्यूजिंग टू एक्सेप्ट. दिस आई लर्नड इन ए हॉस्पिटल, इन ए मैटरनिटी होम. वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड, his wife delivered, but he had some argument with the nurse and she told, if you come inside, I'll call police. It was 2 o'clock at night and he was very anxious to know what happened. So he called me, Swamiji, please come, there's a problem here in the hospital. So I had to go and then he told me the whole story. She refuses me to enter and see my wife and the child. You try something. So I went and talked to that nurse. I knew her language. And then he said, I'll allow you, not him. I said, that is his baby, I am not interested. No, I'll not allow him. He is a very bad person, maybe your friend. So my friend said, okay Swamiji, go and see at least. I went inside and everything was done. And then I became friendly with that nurse and I asked her. I said, hey, this is off the record, okay? The topic is over. Then you tell me, when you people write the time of birth, how do you write? When the tail comes, then the time of birth. Or the head comes, that is the time of birth. And it is not only one lady delivering, there are a dozen of them. So are you staying with the clock then? How do you know time of birth? And you will see in all the patrikas, time of birth is never a round figure. Like Bhagwan Ram and Bhagwan Krishna. Bhagwan Ram was born exactly at 12 o'clock. Bhagwan Krishna was born exactly at 12 o'clock. All of us are born at 11:59. Thoda late karte to Bhagwan ho jate. Then I asked her, I said, how come you decide exactly 7:27? How come? And then forgot, morning or evening? And that becomes our date of birth. Now see, the mother doesn't know exact date of birth. The child doesn't know exact date of birth or time. The nurse also doesn't know. And they tell something. And then my DOB is once. Accepted? We have no experience of birth. Does it mean we started from non-existence? No. The body is imposed on us. Like the house is imposed on the sky. And therefore, sky is inside the house, outside the house. And because our attention is on the walls, we talk the language of inside, outside. But from the spacious point of view, there is nothing inside, outside. In the same manner, we are all born in Him and he is ever existent. And because our attention is at the body, we talk about I am inside the body and you are outside the body. This is called a viparyaya. Unless we change this, that I am not in the body is in me. You don't have to discard the body. Think, the net result will be, we will be living no more as the body, but we will be living through the body. And the one who is living through the body is both inside as well as outside. In Vedanta it is called as Drushya Parichinna Chaitanya and the Drashta Parichinna Chaitanya. When they unite, then the experience happens. So when we have to frighten somebody, we use these terms. But the truth is this. Therefore, Dehat Anyatvar Name Janma, then Jara, old age, Karsha, the weakness, Laya, death, etc. I being other than the body, all the modifications of the body do not belong to me. Therefore, if you have heard, read Atma Bodh, you have lost your right to die. Unless you are from Australia. You ask any Australian, when did you come to die? No, not for the purpose. They will not say today, they said to die. Therefore, after having studied Vedanta or Tattva Bodh, you have lost your right to be dead. Marne bhi nahi denge. See, friends, this is one of the biggest gift. We all suffer never because of death. We suffer because of the fear of death. And therefore, the same question, after death what happens? People will be happy. Gaya. See, friends, Deha Anyatvad Name Janma Jara Karchalaya Daya Shabdadi Vishayehi Sangaha Nirindritaya Nacha. Now, I being without any sense organs, so I do not come in contact with any object. Like, I am talking. Nothing is happening. Because I have discarded the sense organ. You may keep talking. Dekho suno. Samjho mat. Shabdadai vishayi sangaha nirindritaya. Nirindriya, without any sense organs, organs of action. Therefore, all these worldly objects, shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, they have no existence for me. Now this is also very important thing. For a blind person, colors and forms have no meaning. For a deaf person, satsang has no meaning. See? Therefore, we are allowing the world to enter in us through these gateways of the sense organs. That is why on the first day we told you, pratyahar. Ahara means to eat. Prati ahara means not to eat. How not to eat? Keep our sense organs under perfect control. That is what the spiritual practice is. Shabdade vishya sangaha nirindritaya nacha. Continuing further. Amanastvanna me dukkha.
Raga-dvesha-bhaya-dayaha
Aprano-yamana-shubraha Ityadi-shruti-shasanat. So first of all, we have rejected the body. How we cannot be the faculties, body we rejected. Then we have rejected the sense organs. Now we are coming to the mind. Amanastvad name dukkha. I being without the mind, I do not become miserable. So, what is the seat of misery or happiness? Seat of misery or happiness is our mind. Therefore, we told you, mind your mind. That is the real spiritual practice. Nothing happens to body. Everything happens only to the mind. In Bangalore, Narayan Hrudayalayam, my friend wanted to show me the open heart surgery. So we have changed all that tamasha. And when I went, the patient was lying there on the operation table and his chest was open, all machines were running. And my patient, my friend was explaining. I said, hey, finish quickly, mar jayega ye. He said, no, no, nothing will happen, don't worry. Is he not having pain? He said, no, he's under anesthesia. Meaning what? Mind is not allowed to enter. See, is it not our experience? When you have got a pain, you take a painkiller. So, that particular area is under chemical meditation. Suppose you have got something to be operated at the appendages, finger or the toes. They don't give total anesthesia. They give the local anesthesia. And then they cut and do whatever. You can wash that. You don't get pain. That time I had this notion that I am realized a great yogi. They are cutting my toe, but I am not getting the pain. I was so happy. I think I am getting realized. After half an hour, the pain started coming. And then again they had to give me some medicine. So during that half an hour of no pain, the mind was banned entry in that operated area. That day I discovered this truth. Every experience happens only in the mind. And the mind we never take care. Take care of your mind. The real spiritual practice is this. So, a manastvat. Now how do we take care of the mind? Name dukkha. So when the misery is come, they are landed in the mind. But you are not the mind. Then you cannot be miserable. Like when the toe was cut, because the mind was not there, no misery. Disown the whims and fancy of the mind. The mind makes us miserable. Atmaiva atmano bandhu, atmaiva ripuratmana. Our mind is our enemy, our mind is our friend. Don't pamper the mind. But constantly crying, you know. Give one heart, everything comes to down. And this we have trained ourselves. The children, we pamper so much. And all the time we want them to listen to us. Remember, we are all born independently. By accident, we are mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, and guru, shishya. By accident. Bhagavan Shankaracharya very clearly tells, Vishwam pashyati karya karanataya swaswami sambandataha shishyacharyataya tathaiva pitruputra dhyatmana vedataha. The moment cause and effect is established, samsara is born. There is no cause, there is no effect. Cause and effect is an illusion. See? One father was scolding his digitally downloaded son. You know, in today's world, Twameva Mata Cha Pita Twameva. Who is the Pita? Google. Who is the Mata? Amazon. Twameva Mata Cha Pita Twameva. Then, how the child was born? Never born. He was downloaded. Now, such a downloaded child was scolded by the father. I gave you birth and you behave like this with me? He said, Dad, enough is enough. Who told you you gave me birth? So the father started missing his heartbeats. Because we don't know what is coming out of digital alimony. he said, "Dad, I gave you birth. When I was not born, who called you dad?" So the father is because of the son, or the son is because of the father. And who is miserable? The son and the father. Both the men are happy. Understand this principle. Karya karana mithya. And I am not telling Bhagavan Shankaracharya. See, Vishwam Pashyati Karya Karanataya. The moment cause and effect is established, world is created. Then Swami Sambandataha. He is my boss, I am subordinate. She is my wife, I am husband. Shishya Acharya, Guru Shishya. The biggest anomaly. See, friends, get out of all these and be at peace with yourself. This is what it says, a manasvat name raak name dukkha. Therefore, whenever we are miserable, we have chosen to be miserable. Then what Bhagavan can do? Tathastu. Send more miseries. And remember, we are all miserable by our choice. And we are all miserable because of ourselves. If you refuse to be miserable, even God cannot make you miserable. But if you cooperate, then even a neighbor can make you miserable. See? Name dukkham, raga dvesha bhayadayaha. The second part on the mind is raga, the attachment. From the birth up to the age of 5, fondle, love your children. From the age of 6 to 13, discipline them. From 13 to 19, be friendly, inspire them. After that, behave properly with them. Don't carry the burden of your grown-up children. Therefore, yesterday I told you, when a child is born, it's only not a child. The mother, father, in-laws, outlaws, so many are born. Only the child grows, but the mother never grows. Beta khana khaya, are buda ho gaya na. Grow out of these wrong notions. Raga and dvesha. Raga and dvesha, these are the worst enemy in our life. Our whole life is guided by raga dvesha. Desire is nothing but raga dvesha. If we are able to accept the world as it is, everybody cannot be the same. See? Raga, dvesha and the bhaya, the fear. What cannot our enemy think about us? Our mind thinks. Suppose somebody was due to come 7 o'clock. It is 7, 7:30, 8, 8:30, 9 o'clock. And their mind will start thinking, why he is coming so late? I hope there is no accident. And these days the trucks also go. I hope the truck has not gone on his motorcycle. And his motorcycle is smashed. And he's also, train. Mama, agaya. See, what even our enemy cannot think about us, our mind thinks. Therefore, amanastvad name dukkha raga dvesha bhayadayaha. Fear is only imagination of the mind. Apranaha, yamanaha, shubraha, ityadi shruti shasanad. In Mundakomanishad, this mantra comes. Apranaha, amanaha, shubraha, hi amanaha, shubraha. The truth is, without any of this conditioning of the panchakoshas, iti shruti shasanad. Now this reality that we are talking about to be our essential nature is further elaborated in the 33rd verse.
Etasmajayate prano.
Manasarvendriyanicha.
Kamvayurjyotirapaha.
Prithivi vishvasya dharini. Etasmat paramatmanaha. From this paramatma, from this Brahman, from the reality that we are. Remember this. Etasmat. Don't keep Paramatma far away from you. Etasmat jayate. This mantra comes from the Kaivalya Upanishad. एतस्माद् जायते प्राणः। परमात्मा एक्सप्रेसेस इन द बॉडी, फर्स्ट एक्सप्रेशन इज चेतना और लाइफ दैट फॉल्स इन द परव्यू ऑफ द प्रकृति। इन 13 चैप्टर भगवान श्री कृष्ण सेज संघातश्चेतना धृति, द प्रकृति और द मैटर इंक्लूड्स चेतना। चेतना इज नॉट परमात्मा, चेतना इज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ परमात्मा। द लाइट इन द बल्ब इज नॉट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, लाइट इन द बल्ब इज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। सी द फर्स्ट एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ परमात्मा इज प्राण, एतस्मा जायते प्राण लाइफ। देन आफ्टर दिस चेतना और द लाइफ इज बॉर्न, देन मनः लिविंग एज चेतना और प्राण इज गोइंग बियॉन्ड द माइंड। द मोमेंट द चेतना और द लाइफ इज डिग्रेडेड और इवॉल्व्ड, इट इज कॉल्ड एज माइंड। नाउ बी अटेंटिव, लाइफ वाइज वी आर ऑल वन, द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ लाइफ इज माइंड, माइंड वाइज ऑल्सो वी आर ऑल वन। बट देन वॉट हैपन्स, दैट माइंड इज एक्सप्रेसिंग इन ए पर्टिक्युलर बॉडी, देन दैट माइंड टेक्स द शेप ऑफ दैट बॉडी टू बी इट्स ओन शेप, एंड देन द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ द चेतना और द लाइफ एज माइंड इज रिड्यूस्ड टू, फ्रॉम द मैनिफेस्टेशन टू द इंडिविजुअलिटी। सी दिस पॉइंट शुड बी क्लियर। सो परमात्मा एक्सप्रेसेस इन सर्टन कंडीशंस एज लाइफ, लाइफ एक्सप्रेसेस एज माइंड, एंड इट इज द माइंड विच इज कीपिंग द फंक्शंस ऑफ द बॉडी गोइंग ऑन। नाउ दिस माइंड इज कॉमन अगेन, इट इज दिस माइंड विच कीप्स द लाइफ गोइंग इन द कोमा, बट इन कोमा देर इज नो इंडिविजुअलिटी, and therefore a comatose person doesn't suffer. Those who are paying the bills they suffer. Think clearly. Now once we come to this point that as long as the body can express the mind, till then the body is alive. When this body fails to express the prana as a mind, then that body drops dead, like the bulb. Two bulbs, one there is light, other there is no light. What is the reason? Behind a fuse bulb there is no electricity. No, behind a fuse bulb also there is electricity. If it is there, why it is not showing light? In the living man there is Paramatma, in the dead person also there is Paramatma. If Paramatma is there, then why he is not talking to me? Okay, to understand this, behind a bulb which is with the light, there is electricity. Next to that another bulb, no electricity or no light. If there is no light, naturally there is no electricity. Now experience, you do experiment. Remove that fuse bulb and put your two fingers correctly. You will get realization. Oh, yaha bhi hai. So what is the difference? In the normal bulb, the electricity can manifest, express as light. In the fuse bulb, electricity is there, but cannot express or manifest as light. Exactly the same way, our body is like a bulb. When the ability of the body to express the consciousness as life fails, that doesn't mean consciousness is not there. Get this point across, friends. And now this mind which is expressed in the body, when adopts the shape of the body, what is called the waker or waking experience. And after this waker is born, then mano pranaha, then sarvendriyani cha. Now that mind is expressing through the holes called as the nanendriyas, karmendriyas. And in this manner, out of one absolute reality, the whole expansion takes place. Urdhva Moolam Adashakam Ashvattam Prahuravayam. See? So, Paramatma, expression as life, life expresses as mind, mind expresses as sense organs express as the objective world. Like this telescopic antenna, it is so small, you pull it, opens in a particular sequence. If it is a wire, it will get entangled. But if you have to collapse, put it, it goes the reverse way. Exactly the same way. Paramatma expressing as life, as mind, as sense organs, as the objects. So go back. यच्छेद्वांग मनसी प्राज्ञ तद्यच्छेद् ज्ञानात्मनि ज्ञानात्मनि महति नियच्छेद् तद्यच्छेद् शांति आत्मनि कठोपनिषद टेल्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विड्रॉ फ्रॉम द ऑब्जेक्टिव परसूट, कम बैक टू योर सेल्फ, देन विड्रॉ फ्रॉम द इंडिविजुअलिटी एंड मर्ज इन द मैनिफेस्टेशन. व्यक्ति डिस्कार्ड, कम टू द अभिव्यक्ति. And when we come to the abhyakti, name dveshvasti na priyaha. Like the sense organs, for example, eyes, have no likes and dislikes for any color and form. Ears have no likes and dislikes for any sound. Mind doesn't have any likes and dislikes for any sense organ. The chetana, the life, doesn't have any likes or dislikes for anything, whether it is the upper end or the lower end. The life is the same, and the pure consciousness doesn't matter whether it is a holy man or an unholy man, whether it is a human being or an animal, the consciousness is a common factor. This journey from the manifest to the unmanifest is the spiritual practice. And this will start happening if we are clear at every step. Otherwise, we keep on doing tabla peti and get lost in that. So, etasma jayate prano manas sarvendriyani cha, then kham vayur jyoti rapaha prithvi, then all the five great elements are created out of it, and vishvasya dharani prithvi, and then on this earth the whole life is born. See, friends, are we not doing the same thing every day? We discard all the objects, come to the sense organs, discard them, come to the mind, discard the mind, come to the eye, vijnanamaya kosha. Then eye also is dropped. And when the eye is dropped, the snoring begins. Then again, how do you begin? Moment the eye awakens, first of all, what is the time? Kala. Where I am? Desha. What I am? A satsangi. ओ गॉड, फिर सत्संग को जाना, संसार बिगिन्स. लर्न दिस एवरी डे. इफ दिस टू टाइम्स यू कैन हार्वेस्ट हाउ यू गो टू स्लीप एंड हाउ यू कम आउट ऑफ द स्लीप, टू टाइम्स. तो व्हेन यू गो टू स्लीप, यू योर सेल्फ रिकॉग्नाइज वन डे. First of all, we discard all the achievements and failures in the world. Then we come back to our home. Then there also we discard all the rooms, etc. Then we come to our room. Then there also we discard everything. Go below the quilt. And ultimately, everything is discarded. And the one, be attentive, the one who was discarding, he is also discarded ultimately. The one who wanted to sleep, till he is there, I want to sleep, I want to sleep, sleep will not begin. When that I who wanted to sleep, even when he is dropped, doesn't matter whether it is a satsanga or it is anything else. Therefore, those who sleep in satsanga, they have discarded their ego. See, friends, and he who knows this, he will not get angry if somebody is sleeping in his satsang. And he who doesn't know this, he will become angry. Utha usko. Why should I wake him up? Why is he sleeping? You put him to sleep. Your lecture was anesthetic. See, friends, relax. Don't become serious in life. Continuing further in the 34th verse. Nirguno nishkriyo nityo.
Nirguno nishkriyo nityo.
Nirvikalpo niranjanaha.
Nirvikalpo niranjanaha.
Nirvikaro nirakaro.
Nirvikaro nirakaro.
Nityamuktosmi nirmalaha.
Nityamuktosmi nirmalaha.
Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.